And before we close in on first pitch, a look at the starting lineups here for the finale. And let's also get a brief look at our two starting pitchers as you see how they stack up right there.
101 with a 1.8. Oh, this is a 2-0 with a 0.66. Can't put another hand on my business, can't this nigga?
Vernon Fenn will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. A bit high there. A ball and no strikes. Eric, you take a look at our visiting club as they take the field tonight here in the bottom of the first. They're on a nice little run, winners of four of their last five ball games.
They've been good away from home here, too. They've won three of their first four on this road trip, and that's a sign that these guys are really coming together as a ball club.
And that's off his leg on the mound. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it, it looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue.
Man, nigga,
Roberto
Bourbon
will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s.
I just got a lucky ass hit, nigga, straight up the middle.
First pitch is a changeup for a called strike. He may not throw a ton of changeups here tonight, but he's got a good one when he needs it.
And I think he will need it because this is a good fastball hitting team. Most teams
I need to be
so
concentrating when I was playing this. So I got to actually concentrate on this shit.
Hell yeah.
And a curveball's in there, so he's quickly behind, nothing in two.
That's when he batted, because that shit, he's waiting. Yeah, fielder, really, too, if the ball be coming to you.
Now here's the pitch. And this is lifted out towards straightaway center field. In there, face hit. Around second, he'll try for third. And it's in time as he's out at third as the good relay gets him.
Well, once his ball got out there, you figured it was a sure double. But
I'm trying to be swinging hella early. If I'd have hit that base hit, we'd have had RBI
right there. In scoring position, and here it doesn't pay off.
Rick Peralta is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
The boy boy right
here's
here.
The 1-0.
Get on base.
And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1.
Oh, now there's a location you want right there. If that ball gets hit, you're just going to bang it into the ground all night long.
Ready now on 1-1. Oh, he lifts a high pop up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Hernandez is going to have room as he puts it away right in front of the dugout for the final out of the inning. We've played an inning, still nothing. Sam MacArthur will start things off in the bottom of the second. First offering on the way. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Damn, fuck.
Here's the pitch. And that's lifted in the air out toward left. Borowitz has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Charles Tomori comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. Swung on and missed. 1-1.
Hey, nice and patient. Get your pitch.
Here's the 1-1. 1-2 is the changeup had him out in front there.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. another 1-2. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Fuck.
Brandon Guerrero will get his first chance now. Trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. Fastball off the plate away for ball one. The pitch. Off the plate again. 2-0 now. Very patient here in these opening few innings.
And I think that's exactly what they're going to need to do. The more hitters counts that you can get yourself in, the more fastballs you're going to see. And this is a good fastball hitting team.
Now the pitch. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Moran is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Mark Ullman will dig in now. He had a couple of hits in yesterday's contest. Pitch on the way. Bottom three in the batting order here as the first pitch misses to the number seven hitter. It's ball one. And now pitch on the way. Out in front as he lifts a fly ball out toward right field. Moran has to come in a few steps, but he
has to go over one. That is sweet.
Aaron Romack will stand in, and you see the slow start by the numbers as he's struggling to crack 200 on this new season. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Now the pitch. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2.
Yeah, it's so hard to stay back against a guy like this. Unless you guess right, that thing's just so slow that it's almost impossible to keep from getting out on your front foot.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw gets him, two down.
I ain't scoring shit on me.
Daryl DiMaggio will come forward now. Back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off. Here's a cold strike about thigh high. Nothing in one. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. And the pitch. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
This is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. That alone can be beneficial to an offense.
To 2-2 now.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
I'm out here shitting on this.
Here comes a 2-2. On a big swing, and he crushes this ball deep. My goodness, a long home run. Solo shot here to left, and this ball game is tied at one.
Listen to this motherfucking catcher. I knew I shouldn't have
been for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing in one.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knee.
Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So one run on one hit, which was the home run. No errors, and no one left on base. Roberto Bourbon will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Fastball here as we'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Here's the pitch. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seat.
That's your dude, man? No. I was going to say.
That's the 2-2 pitch.
I'm on defense.
Good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Now here's the pitch. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. A payoff pitch one more time.
Hell no.
Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. And a good throw gets him one gone. Rick Peralta will dig in. He popped out in foul territory his first time. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Here it comes. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now here it comes. On a big curveball that's in there for a ball.
Curveball frozen.
There are two gone.
Fuck.
Third baseman number seven.
Sam MacArthur will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Here's the first offering. And he takes ball one.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
Fourth inning.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. The 1-1. This one's in there. Maybe should have been strike three, but instead it's 1-2 now.
A high fastball that time in the strike zone and on the outside corner. But that is a dangerous spot to be pitching if you're only throwing in the low 90s.
The 1-2. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired.
Another strike
out. Nothing across here this half. We played four full, all tied at 1-1.
What kind of pitcher are you?
What you mean? I'm a starting pitcher.
Like relief starting? Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can't do that relief shit. No point in you getting
Charles
off the
one
two
in. Will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth.
I was going to be a closer, but.
Now here's the first pitch.
Swing
and a miss as he was way in front of that one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. But he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first out.
This play right here is all about getting a great read and a good angle on the ball when it's hit. Great jump, runs it down, and that saves extra bases.
Into the box, Brandon Guerrero. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1.
He's just cruising out there now. I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
Well, got him a swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
Boy, so, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look at.
Now a swing and a ground ball.
I'm going to play the pitch.
On to first, and there are two down. Mark Ullman will try it again. He flew out his first time. Mark Ullman. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
That's by him for strike one. Now the 1-1 pitch. And oh man, that caught him pretty good there as it ricochets toward the third baseline. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. So nothing happening this time around. We're through five here at the ballpark, all tied at 1-1.
Five more hours of
Romack will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had him off balance all game.
He's talking about I'm trying to set a play though, or whatever I got.
He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly
like,
broke the
like
plane
the
rare plate, and that'll be ruled a strike.
Or like the dump
not
people.
Too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but
you can make a sell order.
As long
out
as you're keeping
you
guys
yeah,
off balance,
me.
You're letting your defense help you. You don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2. driven the other way out to deep left field. See you later, over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to left as we are all knotted up at two. And we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen.
I'm going to leave the showcase with this thing, though.
Now the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground.
Got four strikeouts though the first game.
And now a pitch on the way. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. One hit.
No errors.
Vernon Fenn will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. And this was nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Here's the pitch. Still won't get him to fish downstairs, and it's 2-0 now. Pitch on the way. Hit hard and caught down there at third. As he'll hang on here to record the second out. Roberto Orbon will stride in, grounded out his last time through. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. Here's a 1-0. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now. You get the sense he's starting to nibble a bit at the corners here, and that's something he wasn't doing earlier.
Yeah, and he sort of backed off the throttle a little bit, too. I'm wondering if that home run ball might have changed his approach just a little bit.
And he gets the call there, 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. Here's the 3-2 pitch. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. Payoff pitch coming. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. So one run on one base hit, the home run, no error, and no one left. Not a lot of offense to go around in this one, but what offense we did see came from this man's bat. He's our top player.
I gave him three hits, two of them was homers.
Damn.
I didn't need that.
130 crack monster, but it would have been foul. Hey. Got him. Every kind of fortune gets sold.
Every kind of line is gonna come back to me just as I am.
Darren Nichols will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Yeah.
In there for strike 1-0-1.
That was supposed to be the third strike.
Fair to say they're not playing their best baseball right now. Losers of five of their last six.
And it was right on the line, man.
Yesterday behind you. It wasn't their finest performance of the year, that's for sure. But they're capable of playing much better ball. And I think we'll see a sharper focus here in this one.
The 1-2. This ball's grounded foul. Here's another 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. Now here's the pitch. That's hard hit back up the middle. Over to his left. He's up with it. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Vic
Victor Vizcaíno to come forward now. Back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
One thing to keep an eye on as this game goes along, first pitch strikes. The more this guy can work from ahead, the better off he's going to be.
Ooh.
Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2. Okay.
And this battery knows full well that this guy's been scuffling lately. So they're not messing around here. They're coming right after him.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will wind up foul. Still 0-2.
Fuck.
Now another 0-2.
I want the nigga.
The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
And that's his strikeout pitch right there. You know, you'll see a lot of guys swing right over the top of that one. That's a great job there just to hold off.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
He'd obviously love a 1-2-3 here to start the first. And after a ground out and a strikeout, he's two-thirds of the way there.
Jorge Ordóñez will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. Foul back. Now here's the pitch. There's a chopper foul over to the right side. 0-2 now.
Hey,
here's the pitch. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball. A great pitch with two strikes. Started in the zone and then let it work out and see if he'll chase.
Here comes a 1-2. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. An inning in the books. No score here on the show. Daryl Lachlan will dig in now, and he's got to be wondering when his bat's going to make the trip north from spring training, as he has really struggled in the early going. Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. Now the pitch. Swung on and grounded, foul. Ready now on 1-1. Now a swing and a ground ball. One away. Number 35 will stand in now as he was reinserted back into the lineup here after taking a needed day off yesterday. Change up too low, and it's 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. The 1-1. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
And a bouncing ball, foul. He'll try again, 1-2. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2.
Well, I'd be surprised if they go back to the curve again on 2-2. He's had a couple of pretty good looks at it.
Bottom of the second here with no score. Now another 2-2. And here's a ball hit in the air.
I got it.
And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Well, this will wind up nothing more than a pop out in the scorebook. But what won't go unnoticed in that dugout is that he battled for an awfully long time there. That takes a lot of energy out of a guy when he's got to throw that many pitches.
Darren Rich is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike. And now a pitch on the way. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Pitch on the way. And a curveball swung on and missed, and a great call there as the inning is over. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We've played two full, and we are tied 0-0.
Oh, he smacked my shit.
Jamal Fryer will stand in what would appear to be a sacrifice situation here. Now the first pitch. Now here's the ball hit sharply toward the right side.
Ain't no sacrifice situation.
In there, the base hit.
How about that swing? That wasn't just a little bleeder off the end of his bat. He swung that bat like he knew what he was doing up there.
Into the box, Borowitz, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0.
And you know, all you have to do is point back to yesterday's ball game. This was part of their downfall, hitting with runners in scoring position. They just couldn't sustain any kind of offense. So this would be a big boost if he could turn the tide a little bit here and come through big.
And he looks at a slider in there, 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. First and second here with nobody out. Now the 1-2. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
You know, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Sets the 2-2 pitch. And this is lifted in the air out to left. Ordonez has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. And the relay throw is right by him at third base. Alex Ramos will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
Pretty cool right there. You know, it's so important in a tough spot to get that first pitch strike over. And he's able to jump ahead.
Just roasting niggas on Snapchat, nigga. Come on, he roast everybody like this shit or something, nigga.
You said what?
He's ready now. Any pitch. Nigga that
oh, look out! Up and in and nearly took his head off. Can't imagine guys
nigga,
like
up,
that
nigga.
Too much.
And when you make a video,
yeah,
nigga, turn the light off so
you
see your dark ass,
danger
nigga.
Area when
you like one of those cartoon characters that cut the lights off so you see the white eyes, nigga.
And they'll try to go away with this one, but it misses as well, and it's to 2-1 now.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. Now a ball lying to the left side.
Hella ugly, nigga.
But foul.
Yo, nigga, you look like a nigga, it was hella funny, nigga.
Third inning, no score to this point. Comes a 2-2. Well hit high in the air and deep to center field. Vizcaino is back and he'll get there to make the play for route number two.
That ball was hit well and it might have been a different story if he pulled it. Instead, he hit it to the big part of the ballpark and he's retired.
Albert Hernandez will stand in with two on and two out here in the third. First offering on the way. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Here's the 1-0. And that's in there for his strike 1-1. Here's the 1-1. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Here's the 1-2. And he'll try to entice him with the changeup here, but it dips below the knees. It's 2-2.
That's a good idea, 1-2 right there, just to see if he'd chase. But now with the count even, I think this one has to be in the strike zone because you don't want to run the risk of loading the bases for the cleanup guy.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for naught. We've played 2.5, no score on the show. Justin Pelletier will get his first opportunity now, and you can see that average pushing up near 350 to start things out.
Now
here's the first pitch. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start an at-bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
Here's a 1-0. Not quite reaching 90 with the fastball, but it's 1-1 now. Now here it comes.
Well, that's a full pitch right down the middle.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
1-2. Fastball call, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Yeah, he essentially tripled up there. That means he threw the same
pitch.
Oh,
wow, they played me.
Three times in a row. You don't see that very often, but it's going to work out for him as he gets some strikeouts.
Into the box now, R.D. West. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The 1-0. Just missing here, 2-0.
Well, it's looking like this might be their best chance to get that first base runner out there. And really, this has been one of the few guys that's even been ahead in the count.
That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now. Bonnie gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Swing and a miss as he starts the frame with back-to-back strikeouts here. Three in a row going back to the last inning, and there are two away. Rich Sanchez will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Here we go, guys.
Here it comes. Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball, 1-2.
Now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. It'll take a little swing out, try to drive something the other way.
Here he comes on 2-2. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Full count offering on its way. And this is going to be a foul ball. Once again, a 3-2. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special.
I'm just following this pitcher. I don't like this cool to play
Nichols.
A pitcher.
Will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Not much to shout about for either team here as we start the fourth inning, nothing.
Yeah, I think we kind of knew that pitching might take the upper hand here. Maybe not to this extent,
but
both guys have really thrown the ball.
I'm doing all right.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
You probably like 55 over there. Huh?
Here's the 2-1 pitch.
Oh!
And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
Oh, I think he'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
3-2. Here's the 3-2 pitch. And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth. Victor Vizcaino stand in now, and he'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful. Jorge Ordonez will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. Now a swing and a fly ball, but this is going to wind up a foul ball.
He's going pretty good, though.
Boss, now the pitch. strong swing, and this is fouled straight back right off the catcher's mask, and that might have dazed him for a moment here. Comes set, now the pitch. Fouled straight back.
You just started your dude over?
Another 0-2 coming.
And
a big curveball is in there.
Curveball,
third strike, and there are two gone.
Well, right now he is just.
How you get four pitches?
Dare
only
I
got
say,
three.
Like a Thanksgiving
got three.
Turkey. That's seven strikeouts already, and he's made it look easy so far.
Darryl Lachlan will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
They got a fastball, curveball,
and a sharp ground ball to third. Plenty of time, and the side is retired. So
that's
no runs here, no hits, no errors.
You don't got a slider, you got a curveball, you said?
Yeah.
Jamal
Pryor
take a long look down here
ball.
As he may be bunting to avoid the double play.
Yeah, they've been hitting a lot of this, so I'll see if he comes
off that one, and it's strike one. All right, four scoreless innings in the books. What's it going to take to push across our first run?
Nigga?
Well, I think both pitchers have really dominated so
far. Well, you throw a pitcher on me, I can't hit,
nigga. Getting the leadoff guy on is so key. You know, get the pitcher into the stretch, get him out of his comfort zone.
I'm gonna swing at
that. Maybe your offense can go from there.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
Fuck.
Right-hander deals on 1-2. And fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Look at him.
Number 35.
Wow, he gonna lob the ball hella high.
Here in this one.
Wow, he could have had it out. That nigga would have just threw the ball regular. This nigga lobbed the ball
much,
and shit. I'm right on the base
one.
In front of him.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far.
This nigga
not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. Really? I mean, that is perfect location, right on the knees.
The pitch. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate.
Oh, got him,
and it's one
nigga.
And two.
You chased that one, nigga.
That curveball is not an easy one to take on an 0-2 count. That's a great job of holding off.
Tried to shoot the corner, and he missed it. 2-2. And good
bro,
patience to hold back on the curveball
in
the dirt. It's full now. 3-2. And the pitch. Hard hit towards center.
Of course, then he throws strike, man.
And he'll have himself a base hit.
That shit belted. His first fucking hit.
And he will make it there with their first hit of the ball game, a leadoff double.
Well, this is one of the few mistakes he's made all game long. Not too many guys have made solid contact so far, but he squared that one up pretty well.
Darren Rich will stand in now with a good chance to break the seal here following the leadoff double.
I'm on the Rangers.
Well, it's a good RBI opportunity, but you've got to remember your first job, which is to at least get that guy over to third base.
I'm on the fucking Texas Rangers.
He's set, now the pitch. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1. Here's
I'm
the 1-1 pitch.
College.
Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here comes the 1-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ball game for him. There's our line score through the first 4.5. And these guys have basically had the bats taken right out of their hands. Just one hit to this point. Here's the first offering. Justin Pelletier stands in as he looks at a called strike.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy
number
up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw
what?
Anything off of.
Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
Hello.
And here's a fastball on 0-2, but it misses 1-2 now.
Could be that high fastball there was just a setup pitch.
I can't even
understand. Kind of
hey, why your phone so loud? Why your phone why
could
so loud?
Could be a good time to break off a nasty curveball.
Oh,
pitch in the dirt,
swung on
and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now. R.D. West will stride in again. Struck out swinging his first time. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike. Nothing in one. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
No taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
And you will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Five innings have been no problem as he's got the shutout working. We're through five here at the ballpark, and we still have no score. Rich Sanchez will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth.
I don't believe you.
The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
And I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first five innings. They're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that throw on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
1-1 on the way. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. The 1-2. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ball game.
Yeah, he's able to set down his opposite number there.
I knew something
with him,
like, I knew something
different about
what he
is. These two guys have pretty much matched each other pitch for pitch so far.
And now a left-hander will start to get ready in the bullpen. Now the first pitch. Darren Nichols comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Well, you know, things have gone his way more often than not so far this afternoon, but he certainly didn't get any help on that one.
Line hard to center field. Base hit. Victor Vizcaino will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway center. Franco is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Jorge Ordonez will stand in, called out on strikes his last time. High and away on the first pitch fastball there. It's ball one. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Here comes a 1-2. Runner goes for second. And the throw is in time as the strikeout and play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Jamal Pryor will stand in now. He singled and struck out in two trips. First pitch coming. And they start him with one high and away for ball one. Well, for that man right there, only the one run allowed. How discouraging is that when you're pitching your heart out and you're just not getting the support?
Well, the good pitchers really don't let it get to them. They know that it cuts both ways. Sometimes you give up five runs and your guys score you eight. You just have to focus on holding up your end of the bargain.
Now the 1-2. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Rich is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. And we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Now the pitch. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. Now here's the pitch. In there, 1-2 now. Pitch on the way. A little low, it's 2-2. Here's the 2-2 offering. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Yeah, it's a good battle to start this inning. That's what you like to see when you've got a guy out there that's getting up there in the pitch count.
And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. Got him as he just continues to mow down these hitters. 13 strikeouts now.
Getting that first out is always critical in a one-run ball game. They could certainly use a quick seventh inning.
Number 35. Step in now. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 thus far. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Now the pitch. missed low and inside with it. 1-1. Bases are empty. One man out. The 1-1 home. That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still here in the catcher's mitt, snapping all the way up here.
Struck him out and make it 14 punch-outs now in the game.
Well, we've talked about it already, but this has just been an absolutely dominating performance out there. That's 14 strikeouts.
Stepping in now, Darren Rich. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one. Here's the pitch. And it's a called strike to even the count at one. Next pitch will be number 100 for him now through 6 2/3. Now the 1-1. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. I'll tell you, he's been living on that corner all afternoon.
And you can tell, guys at the plate, they're starting to get frustrated. He just hasn't made many mistakes.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Add another zero as it's up to 7 shutout innings so far. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. The Bay Bears lead it 1-0. Preston Gilmet will be summoned from the bullpen now, so he'll take over to start inning number 8.
We need to cut the
Justin Pelletier will dig in now, hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. First pitch coming. And boy, a high strike called there. That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one. Well, that man right there is into his 8th inning of work now. Any concerns going forward?
Well, I think the only thing you have to worry about is that pitch count you see right there. Other than that, he's earned the right to stay out there. Usually the other team will tell you when you're starting to get tired.
Now here's the pitch. Struck him out. Strikeout number 16 thus far as he's had a whale of a ball game.
Yeah, he just keeps rolling right along. Shut out intact as you get a look at his line so far. Through 7 1/3 innings now, they've just not been able to mount any type of offense against him at all.
R.D. West will stand in 0-2 thus far. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hit hard back up the middle. And he is going to reach. It's a base hit.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
Skipper's out of the third base dugout on his way toward the mound, and he's going to make a move as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Robert Whitehead will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, really a dominating performance out there. Look at all the strikeouts. I mean, they just couldn't touch him.
Make it.
that nigga Banner still on this other shit. He on Snapchat talking shit?
Yeah. That nigga turned his light on though, nigga.
Yeah. Where this nigga at?
Riding out versus everybody in the motherfucking snap right now, nigga. It's me. Riding out versus everybody.
Funny. Nigga, I still see one of the motherfucking lights though, nigga.
Yeah, respond to me. He ain't say nothing to me though. Nigga, you hurt. That nigga just said LOL to me.
Aww, you scared of Day Day, nigga. Nigga, you scared of Day Day, nigga.
Nigga, don't want this, nigga. This nigga don't want this.
Nigga talking about a skateboard, nigga. Talking, nigga, with that motherfucking mic on your motherfucking head, nigga. You go do something about that shit. Them nappy ass dreads you had on, I ain't blowing 6 years, nigga.
That nigga's hitting 6 years, though.
I'd rather have a motherfucking skateboard on my head than a motherfucking dirty ass mop, nigga. Been cleaning the same fucking floors for 6 years, nigga.
Nigga, I'd rather have a motherfucking skateboard on my head than a motherfucking dirty ass mop, nigga. Been cleaning the same
floors. Hey, you got that motherfucking mop on your head, nigga. First off. Second, I see you turned that motherfucking light on, nigga, with your crisp ass, nigga.
Hey, you got that motherfucking mic on your head.
It's your crisp ass.
Second, I see you turned that motherfucking light on, nigga, with your crisp ass, nigga.
I'm gonna be rushing this nigga all day now, man. I'm gonna pack all black on everybody. Look, nigga, I got Mike with me. I'm like, chilling my nigga Mike. You can't see him unless he opens his eyes, you feel me? Hot, nigga.